Plex.Earth 3, importing and exporting. Publishing AutoCAD projects to Google Earth. First, we're going to set up the parameters for the publishing process. Click the Publish to Google Earth button. When prompted to select objects, especially if it's the first time you use this command, it's recommended that you continue without any selection in order to set up the exporting procedure through the wizard. Press space and you will enter the Publish to Google Earth wizard. Next time you use this command, feel free to select the objects you wish to publish and you will be automatically directed to the final step of the process, thus saving time. Press Next and you will be prompted to enter a coordinate transformation method. The Use Coordinate System option, which is selected by default, is the preferred option as it automatically detects your previously selected zone and units. However, you can also select the user-defined transformation, where you will be prompted to correlate a point from within AutoCAD to a point in Google Earth. This approximative method is usually selected when the project you wish to publish is not already set up in a coordinate system. Once you've completed your selection, click Next, where you will be prompted to select the objects you wish to publish, as well as set their appearance in Google Earth. You can either select all the objects of the project, or select only the ones you wish to publish from the drawing. Complete your selection by pressing space. If your project contains text, it's recommended that you enable the Publish Text option in order for text to appear on your published project. The Render Text as Placemark option will publish text in your project in the form of Google Earth's placemarks so that you can manipulate it from within Google Earth. When selecting the Publish Points option, points of your AutoCAD project will appear as editable placemarks. The Publish Entity information is used in order to export object data, for example GIS information. As a result, objects will change their data when exported, thus enabling the user to view the attached information from within Google Earth. This option, however, is available only when using AutoCAD Civil 3D and Map 3D. By selecting the retained line thickness, the line width of your project will remain when publishing to Google Earth. However, you should be careful when selecting it, as this can result in progressively blurred representations of your project as the eye altitude of Google Earth increases. The Display Edges on Filled Areas option enables the display of the polygons within which the fills and hatches of your project are placed. Finally, as Google Earth does not support curved objects, the Circle Parts and Spline Precision options are used to establish the precision with which curved objects in your project will be approximated when published to Google Earth. Once you've set up the publishing options, click Next. There, you will be prompted to select the save location of your publish. By default, your exported file is saved inside your AutoCAD projects folder. Here, you will also be prompted to select the file format of your published project. As a rule of thumb, the KMZ format is preferred for its full exporting capabilities, while the KML format is only used for simple line work. Here, you can also select the elevation mode of your project. The Elevation Relative to Ground option publishes your project with the Z values applied as an offset of the ground level in Google Earth. This implies that your project's Z coordinates must be converted to relative ones, based on a zero height, before using this option. The Elevation Relative to Sea Level option is used to publish your project in absolute coordinates. Note, however, that if for whatever reason there is a discrepancy between your drawing's Z values and those of Google Earth, your project might appear either elevated or immersed into the ground. The Drape Entities on Ground is the preferred option when working with two-dimensional drawings, as your project will be clamped to ground level in Google Earth. Finally, you can also customize the placemark style for your publish. You can choose from a list of available placemark styles, either from AutoCAD or Google Earth, or you can even add your own style. After you've completed the wizard, just click Finish and your project will be automatically converted to your selected file type. Open it, and your project will be published to Google Earth. Plex.Earth has now created a detailed model of your project inside Google Earth's temporary places, complete with the layers of your original drawing. Every layer and object that has been published can be turned on or off or edited in the same way as any element in Google Earth. You can now use your KMZ or KML file to send it to colleagues, associates, partners or customers to easily share your published project as a visualization in a real-world environment. Publish to Google Earth enables the user to create a detailed representation of an AutoCAD project both in 2 and 3 dimensions within Google Earth. The Publish feature supports the export of line work or any object type, for example text, hatches, blocks, attributes and others, while text or point objects can either retain their default AutoCAD formatting or be exported in the form of Google Earth's placemarks. The published project retains all the original layer properties of the original project, which can now be manipulated inside Google Earth. When working with the Civil 3D and Map 3D object data, for example GIS information, this information will be exported as attributes, which can be viewed from Google Earth. Importing and exporting, created by Plex.Earth support team.